Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my English literature class. Children, I am Anjana Jindal and I am back here with chapter number 5 of our Mulberry book. And the topic is In Conversation with J.K. Rowling. So children, it is part 4. And in the previous videos, means the previous parts of this chapter, I had explained to you the conversation between Rowling and the interviewers, some question answers and few exercises, the word meanings, all that we had discussed in the previous videos. So now in this part 4, in this video, I'm going to discuss rest of the exercises of this chapter. Okay, and with that, our chapter will be completed. So let's learn. Now here's the exercise word wall, and the questions are based on compound words. Okay, let's see question number 1. Each set of the words given below can form compound words using the same word. So children, here the sets of words are given here, right? Many sets of words are given, and each set can form compound words. And how to form compound words? By adding a same word to all the three words in a set. Okay. Now, follow the example, as one example is already given to you. Yes. And choose the right word from the help box to change each set into compound words. So, let's see the example. As the set of words was given as lore, tale and song. So, a same word, one word is being added to all the three words, no? The whole set. Right? To form the compound words like folklore, folktale and folk song. So the same way we have to do for others also. So now next set of words we can see fly, boat, work. So children, let's see from the help box which word is suitable here to form the compound words. Fire, sea, eye, fog, house, bed, out, sun. So house fly, yes, house, this word we can take. House fly, houseboat, housework, isn't it? Yes. Let's see the next one. Lash, ball and bro. So let's see the words. Yes, I, we can take the word I, isn't it? We can add the word I. So the compound words will be formed as eyelash, eyeball and eyebrow. Now see next one. Doors, fit and grow. So which word will be suited here, will be best fitted here? Out. Yes, we can take the word out. Let's add outdoors, outfit and outgrow, right? Let's see the next set of words. Time, room, spread. So children, see here. Bedtime, bedroom, bedspread. Yes, this we can take. So let's see. Bedtime, bedroom, bedspread. Isn't it? Yes. Now next is flower, light and set. Let's see the words in help box. Sunflower, sunlight. Yes, we can take this word sun. Okay. Sunflower, sunlight and sunset. Okay. Now next set of words. Place, fly and works. Let's see how many words are left. Only two words are left. Fire and sea. Just all have been used. Isn't it? Yes. So here we can use fireplace. Yeah. Let's use this, the word fire. Okay. So see. fireplace, firefly and fireworks. Right? Now the last one, girl, shell and shore. So only one word is left, that is sea. Seagull, seashell and seashore. So this exercise you can do in your book very neatly. Okay. So children, now question number 2 of word wall is, make sentences of your own with the following words. Means a box is given to you. See, here is the box. Here are the words. Okay. You have to use these words and you have to make the sentences of your own. Right? Yeah. So let's see. The first word is strolled. So let's see the sentence. Children, you can form other sentences as well. Means you can make the sentences of your own also. Okay, I have given my sentence, but you can change also. So first one is strolled, and I have made the sentence as Megha strolled around in the park near her house. Right? Now the next word is encouraged. So let's see the sentence which I have formed for you. My teacher encouraged me to write a story. Okay. You can write another sentence as well. Any sentence of your own choice. But that must be grammatically correct. Okay. Yes. Now let's see the next word. Next word is prevented. So see the sentence. Yes. The police prevented the mob from entering the university. Right? Now, let's see, the next word is managed. So, let's see the sentence using the word managed. Yes. I managed to reach home before it started raining. Fine? Now, the last word is realized. So, let's see the sentence. Yes. She realized that she had made a mistake in her maths exam. So these are the sentences which I have formed for you. Okay. You have to just write down in your copy very neatly. So children, now here is the next exercise, grammar time. So the questions are based on the grammar time, that is, see question number 1 here. Circle the verbs that agree with the nouns in these sentences. So children, this question is based on subject verb agreement, right? Yeah, subject verb agreement. Yeah, so we all know the meaning of agree means when we talk about subject verb agreement, no? So we mean matching nouns and verbs according to number. Number means singular or plural, isn't it? Yes, it depends on the subject. Is it a singular or it's a plural one? Let's see. See the A part. Caterpillars turn or turns into butterflies. So you have to circle the correct verb. So which verb will agree with this subject, this noun, that is caterpillars. See children, caterpillars, here it is a plural noun, no? Yes. So with plural noun, we will use the verb turn, right? So caterpillars turn into butterflies. Next one, a butterfly fly or flies from flower to flower. So a butterfly means singular number, right? So with singular noun, we will use the verb flies. A butterfly flies from flower to flower. C part. The student monitors help or helps the teachers. So children, here the student monitors. It's a plural subject, isn't it? Student monitors. Monitors are plural. So we will use help. The student monitors help the teachers. Now D part, the students do or does their work. Again, the students, it's a plural subject, plural noun, so we will use do. Okay, so the students do their work. Now E part, the men is or are planting trees on the hill. So children, men, it is a plural form of man. So with the plural noun, we will use are, isn't it? Yes. So the men are planting trees on the hill. Few more sentences are there. Let's see. The women is or are driving tractors. Again, the women. Women, it's a plural form of woman, isn't it? Yeah, so with plural we will use plural verb are. The women are driving tractors. Next one, see the G part. The children was or were playing on the swings. So children, tell me, the children was or the children were? Yes, children were. Because children is a plural noun. Plural of child, isn't it? Yes. The children were playing on the swings. Now, I am or is learning to match nouns and verbs. Yes, am will come with I. I am learning to match nouns and verbs. Yes. Now, let's see. I part. We enjoy or enjoys reading mystery stories. We is a plural one. Yes, so we enjoy. Correct. We enjoy reading mystery stories. Right. Now the last one. They eat or eats lots of green leafy vegetables. So which verb will come with they? They is a plural subject. Right. So we will use eat. They eat lots of green leafy vegetables. So children, this exercise you have to do in your book very neatly. Okay? So children, next question, that is question number 2, is fill in the blanks by using is or are to complete these sentences. So you have to fill the given blanks by using is or are. Okay? Now let's see. First one, A part. The school hockey team dash playing a match this afternoon. So children, the school hockey team. Hockey team. It's a singular subject, right? Yeah, singular noun. So we will use is. Yes. So the sentence will become, the school hockey team is playing a match this afternoon. B part. The players in the team dash very good. So children, here we are not talking about team, we are talking about the players, right? The players which are there in the team. So players are plural, so what will we use? Yes, we will use are. The players in the team are very good. Next C part, the shelf of books dash dusty. Now we are not talking about books, we are talking about shelf of books, shelf. So it is a singular, we will use is. Yes. So the sentence will become as, the shelf of books is dusty. Now D part, the books on the shelf dash dusty. Now you tell children, yes, are, because we are talking about books which are kept on the shelf, right? So the books on the shelf are dusty. Now the travelers in the bus, yes, we will write are. The travelers in the bus are tired. Travelers are tired, now which are sitting in the bus? Yes. That's why are. Now the last one. The bus full of travelers dash driving up the hill. So children, the bus full of travelers. The bus. So bus is will come, right? Yeah, singular subject, no? Singular noun. Yes. The bus full of travelers is driving up the hill. So this also exercise you have to do in your book very neatly. Okay. Now children, let's see question number 3. In the sentences given below, circle the subjects and underline the predicates. So here the exercise is based on subject and predicate. Okay. You have to separate the subjects and predicate. Let's see the first sentence. The earth orbits the sun. So children, here we have to separate the subjects and predicates. It's not necessary that you have to circle the subject and underline the predicates only. You can separate also. Okay. So the earth orbits the sun. Children, what is the subject here? Children, subject is that part of a sentence about which something is said, isn't it? Yes. And predicate is that part which is said about the subject, isn't it? Yeah. Whatever is being said about the subject is the predicate part of the sentence. So here, yeah, the information is given about the earth. So the earth is the subject and orbits the sun is the predicate. Okay. Children, you can circle the subject and underline the predicate also, or you can separate the subject and predicate in this way also. It's your wish. Okay. So now let's see the next part. B part. Musicians compose, play and sing music. So here the subject is musicians. Yes. And rest of the part is predicate. That is compose, play and sing music. Now the C part. Amelia Earhart was the first woman to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. So what is the subject here? Yeah, Amelia Earhart. Yes. And the predicate is was the first woman to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. Now let's see next part, that is D part. The bumblebee bat is the smallest mammal. So the subject is, yes, the bumblebee bat. Because we are talking about the bumblebee bat, right? Yeah, something is said about the bumblebee bat, that it is the smallest mammal. So the subject is the bumblebee bat and predicate is the smallest mammal, right? Let's see the next one, that is E part. Galileo built a telescope. So here the subject is, yes, Galileo. And the predicate is built a telescope. Next, F part. Pavonami ran the marathon. So what is the subject? Yes, Pavonami is the subject and ran the marathon is the predicate here. Now next sentence, G part. The camel is known as the ship of the desert. Yeah. So here something is said about, some information is being given about the camel. Yes. So the camel is the subject here. And predicate is, yes, is known as the ship of the desert. Rest of the parts including verb is the predicate. Right. Yes. Now let's see the next sentence, which is the last one. H part. The Eiffel Tower was designed by Gustav Eiffel's company. So the subject, yes, the Eiffel Tower. Subject is the Eiffel Tower and predicate is was designed by Gustav Eiffel's company. Okay. So now these exercises you have to do in your book. Okay. So children, I hope all the exercises are very much clear to you all. And so now the time is for home assignment. And here is your home assignment. That is a writing part. Okay, write well. Paragraph writing. If you could change places with your favorite author or writer for a week, who would you change places with? Write a short composition describing what you would do for that week Here are some questions you could think about. So children, you have to write a paragraph, and here some questions are given for your help. You can think about these, or otherwise also you can write. Right? The questions are given as, what would your daily routine be? What would you do in your free time? And how would you greet your fans? How would you feel when your book becomes popular? What would you say to encourage young writers? Okay, so let's think and write. Later on, this paragraph answer you will get in the PDF form, okay? Okay then, thank you. Bye-bye, take care.